Let's see. things. Anzu hatchlings reach a certain age, the mothers will begin taking them hunting for them. The hatchlings can learn the art of subduing prey, slay the birds both young and old to prevent the fostering of new killers. Anzu prone. Anzu pull it. You survey the surrounding area for a time, but see no sign of him in Allen. Rendezvous with Honor. With Honor. Mistress Fahrenheit, Lord of Manalatin. Lord of Manalatin has been taken by the Bani. They had my lord surrendered, a whole gang of them. Please, you must come quickly. These must be saved. As a display of strength, the young members of the Gundu tribe will taunt the enemy. Their enemies using petty acts of aggression, such as shouting insults or throwing feces. Those especially brave and arrogant, however, will actually physically attack them without someone to bloody their noses. The violence can only escalate. Thank you. Liberty calls, commence battle for a series of unfortunate events of your levels. Above 52 will be sent. The Vanu must have taken him to that village, mayhap to present to their chieftain. I will make haste to the Rose House and tell Lady Laniate what has happened. Yet by the time I return with aid, it may already be too late. Forgive me for asking, Mistress Fahrenheart, but should you spy an opportunity to sneak past the sentries and rescue Lord Imanelline in my absence, I beg you to take it. I know he can be a little presumptuous and insensitive and, well, insufferable, but he doesn't deserve this. Imanelline? Rescue Imanelline. What am I supposed to do on this? Thank you. Oh, the theory, you're not coming to kill me, are you? That's not what you do to prisoners. Rupert, I'm over here. Netherlands, come to free prisoners. Spread word like thunder and cast them into the cloud sea. Chief Honu of Vanu. find my spell, dude. Let's go, dude. Come on, dude, run faster. Go, dude. Go. Oh, run. Come on, see, dude. Come on, dude, run. Run, dude. Let's go. This way quicker.
Reinforcements. Anger of Honu, chief of mighty Vundo, roils like blackest storm clouds. Offer netherlings to the white. Cloud sea swells and he comes.
They sound like me, maybe.
The white, mighty Bismarck, lord of the mists!
That's awesome.
A flying whale? By the fury, it's a primal. We must away. Bloody typical. All right, we're going in.
Aye, aye, Chief.
Frightened me for a fleeting moment at most. Ha ha ha. Hush, if not. We are all of us still alive, my friend. Let us take solace in that most simple of blessings. Gods only know what might have happened had we not been around to save you. No need for thanks, though. It's not as if you haven't done the same for us on a few previous occasions. All right, more than a few. "'Twas but blind chance that brought us together this time, in case you were wondering. The Holy See has petitioned the Ironworks for assistance with their creation, with this creation of theirs, the Protector. Apparently they just can't seem to get her flying. Anyway, I came to Camp Cloudtop to cast an eye over the ship, only to learn that you had arrived some few days before with an Ishgardian lordling in tow. Small world, I thought. Just as said lordling's manservant skittered into view, babbling about his master having been captured and you risking all to rescue him. And the rest, as they say, is history. Right, well, I hate to cut short our reunion, but I am here on business after all, and the boys are already hard at work. Don't worry, old friend. We'll speak again soon, I promise. Very well, I admit it. It was an incredibly harrowing experience. I could very well have died. You know me, dead. On the other hand, by risking life and limb in the line of duty, I did succeed in uncovering the existence of a new primal. And that, old girl, is no small feat. I have made an historic discovery. In fact, even Lady Laniate will have no choice but to acknowledge. Yes, I am rather looking forward to basking in the sunlight of her praise. Speaking of which, isn't it time we made our triumphant return? How do I look? Dashing as always, with a suitable sprinkling of dirt and sweat? Excellent. Let us return to Lady Laniate at once. Speak with Laniate. even after everything he has been through, he manages to remain so optimistic. Thank you, Mistress Fahrenheart, thank you. If you had not rushed to his aid, I dare not think what would have happened. Praise Helona, I feared the worst. What happened out there? A primal, are you sure? Yeah, now that I think on it, this Bismarck is reminiscent of the white whale of Vanu legend, a massive creature said to swim in the sea of clouds. From what I have learned of comparable summonings, the presence of the Vanu's god would certainly explain the sudden change in their behavior toward the people of Camp Cloudtop. Ah, you mean to say that they have fallen under the primal's influence? I recall reading of such things in the documents provided by Master Alfinel. Aren't we forgetting something important, Lady Laniate? A little recognition for the hero of the hour? A few choice expressions of gratitude, respect, admiration, and so on? Why, yes, you are right, of course. Mistress Fahrenheart deserves all that and more for having risked her life to rescue such an esteemed personage. Well, if there is naught else to discuss, I would depart for Ishgard forthwith. The Holy See and the Temple Knights must be informed of this new threat without delay. But of course, Mistress Fahrenheart, you have done more than enough here. Pray return to Ishgard with Lord Hoshafant and give my warmest regards to the Count. So that's it then? No more forays into enemy territory? Very well, I can see my services are no longer needed. Take care, Lady Laniate. May our next meeting take place under more felicitous circumstances. All's well that ends well, eh? To the airship landing then. We can speak on this journey. We can speak on the journey home. All things considered, Imanelain came through relatively unscathed. More's the pity. He might have learned something otherwise. It's Speak with Hashafant in Ishgard. Rose Knight. Who would have thought galley cats would be attracted to catnip? Everyone, you're probably right, but that does not mean we can stand here and watch as the beasts tear through our camp. Lend us your talents, adventurer, and the Rose House will reward you nicely. Cast off the clatter. Well, I suppose the cats will leave once the mint is gone, though we'll still have that vilekin problem to deal with. Mint condition. To stave off the myriad... Whoa. Keep that mint safe. What? To stave off the myriad vilekin that endlessly nip at the cheeks of the Rose Knight stationed in Cloud Top. Several crates filled with seedlings of a natural herb repellent known as catmint were brought in to plant around the camp. Unfortunately, the odor has attracted a cloud of gallicats who have begun destroying the containers to get at their contents. Keep that mint safe, or we'll be elbow deep in vilekin as well. This mint has sent the what? Things into a frenzy. Foundation. Block of the spine. Into a right frenzy. Shit, man. Excitement, glory, all that and more awaits you in the diadem. Should you crave such delights in the depths of your soul, pray return to me when you have honed your skills. In order to embark upon an Ishgardian exploratory mission, you and your party must meet the following requirements. You must have completed the main scenario quest Heavensward, and you must be a level 60 discipline of war and disciple of war and magic to review your quest progression. Select duty from the main menu, followed by journal. Will you be registering for the next mission? If so, you will need to submit proof of purchase for a tank of cerulean. 1,000 pardons, miss. Due to the dangers that our parties often face on these expeditions, we can accept only the most experienced individuals. I confess, I have always been rather fond of airship travel. The chill of the wind upon your face, the warmth of the blood pumping in your veins from the excitement, I find the whole experience indescribably invigorating. Or mayhap it is simply the joy of having cheated death yet again. Haha. In any event, I must make for the congregation and inform Sir Emmerich of all that has occurred. I'm an ally and should have returned to the manor by now. Why not go and see if he has recovered from his ordeal? Speak with Emmerich in Fortum Manor. The Count was utterly beside himself, Mistress Fairheart. It's a mercy you are not here to witness it. It is an honor to have you with us, Mistress Fairheart. Greetings, Mistress Fairheart. How may I be of assistance? First, I questioned your motives and your competence. Unjustly, I now realize. Rumors have a way of growing more fantastic as they spread, and quite frankly, those surrounding you beggar belief. But Hashifan swore that all the stories were true. He championed your cause and begged upon the great patronage. And he duly listened, because for all his wisdom, he has never been able to say no to my dear half-brother, nor to see my father's soul in discretion. Mother hated him, of course, even under deathbed, she refused to acknowledge him. And, to be honest, she was not alone in her feelings. But that is not the worst of it. And Camp Rivers knew. When we came upon the wounded knight, I knew immediately that one of us would have to pursue the heretics alone. An onerous task fraught with danger. And there you were, the savior of Eorzea, an honored guest of House Fortune, a newcomer in arms, Hashifan Steve Turner. I told myself it was to be a test, but part of me hoped that you would fail. Yet you accepted the test without a word of protest, nor any sign of fear, and you duly tracked the enemy down, faced him alone, and left to tell the tale. Then, Hashifan had the right of it all along, that I doubted your strength bespeaks my own weakness. But I will not doubt you again, Mistress Reinhardt. On that you have my word. See, referring to him, for gods did he have to strike me so hard? Father, he did not approve of how I handled matters in Camp Cloudtop, how I endangered the lives of others through my own sniff, recklessness, and incompetence. It's not easy playing the hero, is it? Mistress Fairheart, my lord the Count much desires to speak with you regarding your time with Lord Artorio and Lord Emanella. If you would remain here for a moment.
The hero returns. I cannot thank you enough for saving young Emanellane's life. Aye, he told me everything.
Emanellane? That's how he says his name. Imanellan. 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 Imanellan? Oh, okay. Oh, well, so it's Imanellan. Imanellan.
I've also received letters from both House Samael and Durandir, praising your conduct and that of House Forton. You've won us much honor, my friend.
Samael?
My lord!
What is it? Speak.
Pray forgive the intrusion, my lord, but I bring grave tidings. Master Alfano and Mistress Tataru have been detained on suspicion of fomenting heresy.
What? Explain.
They were observed entering a tavern in the lower levels on some half dozen occasions. There, it is claimed, they made a number of inquiries. Inquiries which brought them into contact with certain elements. It was this which prompted a Knight of the Heaven's Ward to demand that they be questioned. Sir Grinno, my lord.
Grinno.
Sir Grinno is a brute. An exceedingly accomplished brute, but a brute nonetheless. Alas, he is also a son of House Samael. How quickly we forget the petty nature of men. I'd wager your friends are no more than pawns in another of my countrymen's games. Such is the way of things between the high houses.
As wards of House Forton should afford them preferential treatment for a time. Though you have won the hearts and minds of many of my countrymen, there are those who will never be swayed, men who will dismiss your efforts and resent your successes, even as we celebrate them. 'Tis like that one such member of House Zemael. 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 How did he say it? Zemael. He's manipulating Sir Grinno, for he is not a man to dabble in politics of his own volition. He may generally believe your friends to be guilty, though. I am certain his masters know better. Zemael. Yet the truth will avail us not if we cannot prove their innocence. You could do well to speak with Sir Aymeric at the Congregation of our Knights, most heavenly. He will know more of these charges. I know as little as you do of the situation, Mistress Fahrenheart. Sir Aymeric, however, will surely know more.
Thank you.
I had, but this moment resolved to go and fetch you. I presume you have heard what happened then? Sir Amarek has told me much and more about you. Suffice it to say, my expectations are high. That they should regard the signs of such suspicion even after you spread the dust on the steps of faith. It is bad comedy. Yet, unlike the grave injustice you suffered in Elda, which wrong was swiftly derided. This is divinely in assaults hammer us down without cease. I fear keeping record of the destruction will soon be an impossible task. Been too long, my friend. Would that this visit came under happier circumstances. You are come to plead for Master Alfina and Mistress Tataru, I take it. Word of their detainment reached us while I was delivering my report on the Vani Primal. Truly, I know not which is the more ludicrous, these charges or that flying feathered whale. That Sir Grinnell's accusations are baseless, I have no doubt. Refuting them will be difficult, however, as he is a knight of the Heaven's Ward. I speak of the personal guard of the Archbishop, the 12 finest knights in all of Ishgard, sworn to serve His Eminence alone. Suffice it to say, their testimony is unimpeachable, and I have not the authority to challenge their actions. After all the signs have done, routing the heretics and defeating Shiva, helping us to defend the steps of faith and drive back the Dravanian horde, after proving themselves true allies on countless occasions, is there naught we can do? I fear there is but one path left to us. We must demand the trial by combat. But of course, in a trial by combat sanctioned by the Inquisition, the victor's claim is judged true regardless of the petitioner's standing. Under Ishgardian law, a trial by combat puts the accuser against the accused. In this instance, Mr. Alfina and Mistress Tataru would be expected to face Sir Grinnell, and the second of his choosing, another knight of the Heaven's Ward, most like. Two of them? By the theory, that can hardly be considered fair. Master Alfino's magical talents will not have gone unnoticed. meaning that he will have no choice but to participate. Mistress Kataru, on the other hand, is quite obviously bereft of martial skill and should be afforded the right to name a champion to fight in her stead. Lest you doubt, I am ready and willing to serve in this capacity, as I am sure is Lord Hushabon. But all here present know that you are the most accomplished warrior among us, and mayhap in the realm at large. Then it is settled. I will visit Master Alpinar at once and inform him of our intentions, my friend. Meet me at the tribunal when you have made ready. Until then, my friend. The trial will be held at the Supreme Sacred Tribunal of Holonic Inquisitory Doctrine. I'll be in attendance as will many others with a vested interest in the outcome. Stint not in your preparations, my friend. The Knights of the Heaven's Ward will provide a stern test for even one such as you. Sir Aymeric has told me that they should regard the Scions with such suspicion even after you stood with us on the steps of fate. It is bad comedy. Yeah, I'm like, no, it's the same thing. Speak with Hushabon in the pillars.